one of the most important people who did research on Jewry law, in fact, I believe he coined the term Jewry law, is the great historian Guido Kisch. Fascinating individual who was born in Prague, and he taught at the University of Halle until the Nazis forced him out in 1933. He taught for a little while the Jewish Theological Seminary in Breslau, but eventually he left Europe for the United States of America in 1935, and that's, of course, how he survived the war. He did tremendous studies of Jewry law in Germany. And we're going to look in particular at something called the Sachsenspiegel, which is basically a 12th century sort of codification of customary law in Germany, which was his life's work for about 20 years. He ended up, when he came here, he published in 1949 a remarkable book, The Jews in Medieval Germany. This is it. It's a brick of a book. It's really, you know, quite dense and absolutely fascinating. But I want to point out to you one fascinating thing that I just came across. On page 66, he buries this. And it helps me, you know, think about the heroism of previous generations of historians. We really got to just look at this for a second. So what exactly did Kisch do? The thing about medieval law is that, you know, you didn't have like a single code that was like repeated over and over and over again, and people said, well, here's our central code. You did have some of this in the Roman period. We have the Theodosian Codex and things like that. But what you do have is a very important collection called this Sachsenspiegel, of which there are other versions of it. And it was written in the 12th century, in which this writer basically tried to collect what he knew about the customary law of the 12th century in certain parts of what would be today Germany. It's actually quite fascinating. It has a lot of stuff about Jews, and I hope to spend a little more time talking about it shortly. But as this Sachsenspiegel spread, many municipalities said, hey, we really like this. Let's incorporate it. Oh, let's change this little bit. Let's change that little bit. But we'll basically keep it. And so it sort of reverberated throughout the regions. Perhaps the most famous iteration of it is something known as the Magdeburg Recht, the law of Magdeburg, which was a particular city that established a version of the laws that were codified in Sachsenspiegel. And this had lots of implications for Jews, as we shall see in a while. So what Guido Kisch did in the 1910s and 1920s is he went all over Germany and went into local archives, local town halls, said, show me your oldest records. And he painstakingly went through all of these old court cases, thousands upon thousands of them, and noted how they were related to the Sachsenspiegel to be able to write up a massive compendium of how law spread throughout Germany. Huge amount of effort. Then, of course, in the 1930s, when the Nazis came to power, they confiscated all of his papers. He just mentions this, by the way, in passing on page 66 of his book. By the way, I worked on this for 20 years, and then the Nazis just took it all away. After the war, he writes, because this book was published in 1949, he tried to get back some of his documents, but it was all gone. He did know, however, that the Nazis did publish two volumes based entirely on his research without any attribution to him, because, of course, he was a Jew. What goes around comes around, however. The entire institute that had stolen all of his materials was heavily damaged in the last months of the war, and everything was lost, the entire institute, all of their papers and things like that. But what's kind of fascinating is that, you know, Kisch was primarily working as a German legal historian, but he's also a Jew and also interested in Jewish history. So as he's going through his material, he would like make separate set of notes specifically about how do these various legal decisions reflect upon Jewry law. And he ended up collecting a tremendous amount of material, which he didn't turn over for publication because, you know, he was working. This was his side gig, so to speak. But he was able to save those side notes and then come up with this massive book, The Jews in Medieval Germany, A Study of Their Legal and Social Status, which has proved to be an incredible resource for students of medieval law and the Jews. Absolutely fascinating. Thank you very much for watching.